Hello, Hope Church Sittingbourne. Absolute pleasure to be with you again this morning and singing and praising our God. And we're going to start with a song called Lion and the Lamb. And I really encourage you just to lift your eyes this morning, focus on Him, and yeah, just look up into heaven, look up into the heavenly realms and the spiritual realms. And let's take our eyes off the of what's going on around us just for a moment, just to focus on who He is, and then we're going to come back to some stuff in a little while that might be helpful too. So let's sing He's Coming on the Clouds.
He's coming on the clouds, kings and kingdoms will bow down.
Over all I see.
lifted our eyes to heaven, that really helped us to see things as God sees them, that really refocused our perspective. It's been something that has has been relevant to the things that were spoken about in the Tuesday morning Bible study, where it says in Ephesians, "And God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus." That's Ephesians 2 verse 6. So they were talking about being in the heavenly realms, being seated in heavenly places is another translation. We were praying on Wednesday for our town and the local area for salvation, and I really felt like God was kind of helping me to see things in a heavenly perspective again, to not get caught up in what's happening in our day-to-day life, but to see things through his eyes, through his perspective. And then I was also reading a book that about prophecy, and it's talking about how when we prophesy, we need to be seeing people as God sees them. And there's a verse in this song that we're about to sing that sums that up. That sums up the idea that we need to tap into God's heart and see things the way he sees them, to take our place in those heavenly places where God has seated us. So as we sing this and as we sing the next song as well, we're really asking God for a revival, a change in our land that happens when we see what's going on around us through his eyes, and we can pray with his heart, and we can see people as he sees them. And that brings a change, because when we are more like God, when we see things more as God sees them, he makes us more like him, and the image of God that we are made in becomes more apparent as we spend more time in his presence and we ask that he reveal his heart to us more and more. So the rest of the song, as we continue to sing it, and the next one too, is a real prayer that God would change our hearts and bring a change in our community, because we need it. When I say we're not to get caught up in the day-to-day life, it's not that we just ignore what's going on around us, but it's that we see it through the heavenly perspective. We see it as God sees it, so that we can pray and so that we can act and bring a change where it is needed. So is it okay to sing that verse, that bridge, sorry? "Heal my heart and make it clean. Open up my eyes to these things unseen. Show me how to love like you have loved me. Break my heart for what breaks yours. Everything I am for your kingdom's cause, as I walk from earth into eternity."
Heal my heart and make it clean. Open up my eyes to the things unseen. Show me how to love like you have loved me. Break my heart. Break my heart for what breaks yours. Everything I am for your kingdom's cause, as I walk in breath into eternity. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna.
Promise you made that if we turn the
Father God, help us to be faithful in these things. Help us to be your faithful servants who pray, who humble ourselves, who look to your face, look to your promises consistently and continually throughout our lives, God, in this season, in this time that we're in, for the issues that are happening in the world today and the ones that happen tomorrow and the next day and the next day and in the months and years to come. God, help us to always, always have this prayer on our lips. Help us always to look to you, because when we see you, you change us. And when we see things as you see them, we can pray and act and bring change in a world that needs it so much. Start with us, God. Thank you for your promise.
Saved us at becoming children of wrath, as we looked at on Tuesday when we looked at Ephesians. Lord, and kind of wrestled with bringing this song this morning, because sometimes it just feels like it's just for us. But this is to address the roots that can sometimes so easily entangle us, the thought patterns, the negative attitudes, the hurt, Lord, but we want to be a people for your glory. Lord, would revival start in us? Lord, revival start in our homes, in our marriages, in our relationships with our families, our work colleagues.